Hi, my name is Chris Gilbert, and I'm a paleoanthropologist in the Department of Anthropology at the GC and Hunter College here at CUNY. I'm speaking with you today about a recently published paper in the Proceedings of the National Academy of Sciences that has large implications for the timing of early human evolution. Many questions in the study of human evolution and the vertebrate fossil record more broadly require an understanding of time. A fossil specimen by itself is not terribly useful for understanding evolution unless we know how old it is. In order to, for example, correlate paleoclimatic events with early human evolution, or to evaluate ancestor-descendant relationships, or assess rates of evolution in early hominin lineages, or even understand the timing and appearance of distinctive anatomical features, all of these require some understanding of time. Therefore, it is crucial to have accurate age estimates for the geological deposits containing key fossil specimens. For these reasons, determining the geological age of disputed early hominin sites is essential for a comprehensive view of human evolution. In many parts of the world, we're very fortunate to have volcanic rocks, which are excellent for dating because they contain natural isotopes that decay at a known rate. So in the Rift Valley of Eastern Africa, for example, we have very precise dates for all of the early hominin fossils because there has been a lot of volcanic activity in the Rift Valley over the past 2 to 5 million years. So we know exactly how old fossils are in Eastern Africa. In South Africa, however, early human fossils are found in caves that don't have any volcanic rocks for dating. So we have to use other methods to figure out how old the fossils are. One of the oldest and simplest ways to estimate age is to look at the fossil animals themselves and compare them to other fossil animals of known age. If you know, for example, the one specific species of antelope, one species of hyena, one species of monkey, and one species of pig are all only known to overlap between 2 and 2.5 million years ago at sites of known geological age, then if you start finding that same antelope, that same hyena, that same monkey, and that same pig in a cave in South Africa, you can be pretty sure it's probably somewhere between 2 and 2.5 million years old. It might not be very precise in terms of the exact date. We might not know, for example, that it's exactly 2.36 million years old, but it's going to be very accurate in its estimation of geological age in that it's almost certainly somewhere between 2 and 2.5 million years old. Historically, one of the best groups of animals to do this sort of comparative dating has been monkeys. Monkeys are very useful because they are very common during the last 5 million years, and there are numerous species that are found in combination with fossil hominins, and numerous species share between sites in South Africa and sites in Eastern Africa. Recently, there has been some dispute over the ages of some of the caves in South Africa, with some recent studies using new radiometric methods suggesting that some of the caves in South Africa, particular famous site known as Sterkfontein, which is in the background behind me, suggesting that Sterkfontein is around 3.5 million years old or even slightly older. Now, given the ongoing dispute, we decided to take a look at the monkey fossils, which have not been studied in a comparative dating way in over 30 years. So my colleague, Dr. Steve Frost from the University of Oregon, and myself traveled around the world to look at every major collection of fossil monkeys from Africa, went through all the fossil monkeys known from every major site in both Eastern and Southern Africa, and on this basis, we were able to provide some insight into the likely ages of many of the disputed South African cave sites. Perhaps most significantly, we were able to document the evolution of one fossil monkey species, Therapithecus oswaldi, which is a relative of the living Gelada baboon, that is found in both Eastern and Southern Africa. And it steadily increases in size through time, such that its tooth size is highly correlated with geological age. In essence, these monkeys act as fossil clocks. And if you have a large enough sample size of teeth, you can estimate geological age with a very high degree of accuracy because there's only a short period of time that the monkey was at a specific size. So at 3.5 million years ago, for example, the monkey was the size of a small baboon, but by 0.5 million years ago, it was the size of a female gorilla. So by using the size of the teeth of Therapithecus oswaldi, we were able to re-examine the age of a number of famous early hominin sites in South Africa and determine that there is no evidence that any of the South African cave sites are older than about 2.8 million years ago. And that's despite recent claims of some caves being 3.5 million years or older. So there's no fossil monkeys that suggest an age over 2.8 million years ago, and the size of the Therapithecus oswaldi specimens known from South Africa are all simply too large to possibly come from any site older than about 2.8 million years ago. In some ways, our study is almost an exact replay of a similar dispute that took place over 40 years ago when paleoanthropologists argued over the age of an early hominin skull found in Kenya. In this famous case, a group of scientists using new dating techniques argued that a key volcanic deposit near the new fossil skull was close to 3 million years old, while another group of scientists studying pig evolution pointed out that the fossil pigs from the area were most clearly similar to those found at other fossil sites known to be close to about 2 million years old. The pig experts knew this because pig teeth also changed steadily and noticeably through time, such that 2 million year old pig teeth look very different from 3 million year old pig teeth. Ultimately, the pig experts were proven correct. And as the new dating techniques were further refined and perfected, the volcanic deposit was indeed shown to be close to 2 million years old rather than 3 million years old. You can read about this episode for background if you want to get on Google and just Google KBS Tuff, T-U-F-F. Just write KBS Tuff Controversy in Google and you can get some background on that famous episode from 40 years ago. So similar to the KBS Tuff Controversy, the recent studies suggesting ages of 3.5 million years and older at Sterkfontein are using new dating techniques that maybe haven't quite worked out all the kinks yet. Thus, just like with the pigs and the KBS Tuff, here, the monkeys are suggesting that these newer dating techniques are likely incorrect and they need further refinement. Again, all of the monkeys from Sterkfontein are otherwise only known from other areas that are known to be closer to 2.5 to 2 million years old, not 3.5 million years old. And as we've seen before with the KBS Tuff, the fossil animals never lie. Thank you so much for listening. And I hope you enjoy the paper, and I hope to see you around CUNY sometime soon. Thanks so much.